10月14日晚，第二届联合国全球可持续交通大会在北京开幕。联合国秘书长古特雷斯在致辞时表示，要加快所有交通工具脱碳，推动实现2050年净零排放的目标。古特雷斯指出，新冠疫情令各国经济进入紧致，全球道路交通活动减少一半。虽然这使得交通事故减少，空气质量改善，温室气体排放迅速下降，但是这些暂时的进展并没有持续下去。
We are further from realizing sustainable development goals on climate, ocean and biodiversity than we were when they were agreed 6 years ago. We are already close to the 1.5 degrees Celsius upper limit agreed in Paris. The door is closing for action on climate, nature and pollution.
古特雷斯说，交通运输占全球温室气体排放的四分之一以上，加快可持续交通建设，促使所有交通工具脱碳，才能推动实现2050年净零排放的目标。
Priorities are clear. Phase out the production of internal combustion engine vehicles by 2035 for leading manufacturing countries and by 2040 for developing countries. Zero emission ships must be the default choice and commercially available for all by 2030 in order to achieve zero emissions.In the shipping sector by 2050. Companies must start using sustainable aviation fuels now in order to cut carbon emissions per passenger by 65% by 2050. All stakeholders have a role to play, from individuals changing their travel habits to businesses transforming their carbon footprint.
古特雷斯指出，公交服务应成为城市交通的基础服务。我们不仅要让公共交通更加便捷，还应加强交通运输系统应对灾害的能力，提升可持续性。
Much existing infrastructure, from ports to public transit, is vulnerable to extreme climate events, which are happening with greater frequency and severity. We need better risks analysis and disaster planning, even as we scale up solutions. Increased finance for climate adaptation.Is essential for investment in sustainable, resilient transport systems, especially in developing countries.
在2009年哥本哈根气候大会上，发达国家曾承诺在2020年之前，每年向发展中国家提供至少1000亿美元资金，帮助后者应对气候变化挑战。古特雷斯指出，这一目标低估了实际需求，即便如此，仍远未实现。
I reiterate also my call for all of all climate finance in support to developing countries to be allocated to adaptation. We must funnel both public and private resources towards sustainable infrastructure in developing countries to drive a recovery from the pandemic that accelerates progress across the sustainable development goals.
他强调，未来九年，全球必须转向使用可再生资源，而可持续交通是这一转变的核心所在。本次大会将是一个重要机会，激励所有人为建设可持续交通运输系统采取行动。